Greetings and welcome to Astronomy at Hack. The purpose of this video is to walk you through and show you the course navigation that will be used for this class. Now you will see that this specifically says Astronomy 104. That doesn't mean my navigation is the same for multiple classes. So you will see the same type of navigation if you happen to be taking, for example, Astronomy 103 instead. So the navigation is set up to make the course extremely organized so that you have to follow the same pattern each week. And what you'll do is use the course navigation bar to link through. And the course navigation bar is up here at the top. So you see that up here. And that has all of the links, except that you can kind of ignore this over here, faculty links. You will not see that one as a student. That has specific links that I need to be able to access, but does not have anything that you'll be able to see. But essentially, all you need are these four links to be able to navigate everything in the course. Course Home will take you to the course homepage, which is where we are right now. So that will take you to the course homepage and show you exactly this. The content button is the primary one that you will be using for the class, and that is this content button right here. You will use that to access most content, and I'll show you that in a minute. The grades button gives you access to your grades, so you'll be able to access your grades from there. It will show you all of your current grades, every assignment that's been graded. Now, the others that you can use are the communications links and the resource links. Now, these open up to menus. So if you click on communication link, for example, what it will show you is the different links that are there. So the chat and email links are available through this, as well as the class list, the news, and the pager. So if you're communicating with other students or me, email for me is the best way. But if you choose to chat or use the pager for others, for fellow students, you can use that as well. And you can also access the news in the class. Now, the resource links gives you other resources, including links to the library, the calendar, and some of the smart thinking tutoring that you can use as well, and some tutorials. So there's some extra links that you can use there. However, the main thing that you want to use for this class is going to be the content button. So let's look at that in a little bit more detail here. So we click on the content button. If we click on content, it will take you to the class content. And what you will see is, in this case, we'll start off with the table, a complete table of contents, which will show you everything that is available. So for example, as you're starting the course right here, where you're looking at this, you'll be able to see the introduction and the syllabus information, which includes this video. So hopefully you found that already since you're watching this video. It also gives you some information on some of the projects that are done for this class. There is a practice lesson that you may be working on, gives you some ideas of how the course is organized and a little hands-on practice. But what I want to do is look at one of the specific lessons, and in this case, lesson one on motions of the sky. So when we click on that, we will see that the motions of the sky lesson is divided into three main sections and one extra file as you're going through here. The first section will contain the lecture materials. So when you look at that, the lecture materials up here include some sample questions as to what you should learn about the chapter, any specific lecture materials or links that I want you to look at in the lecture materials here, PowerPoint slides, and then video lectures. Now, what you might find in this case is that there might be more than one lecture. I have sometimes have them split up. It will just depend on the specific lesson. But in any case, you might find, instead of one longer lesson here, you might find three or four shorter lectures divided into parts. But in any case, you will find specific slides and video lectures for each of those. So you can print out the PowerPoint slides if you like, and are able to follow along with the lecture as you watch it. Now, the second section that we see is the discussions section. And when we scroll down to the discussions in this case have several different sections to them. And we'll start off with the first one up here has class introductions. Of course, that will only be visible this first week. Once we're done with the first week, the class introductions will be done and we'll be on to other discussions. Each week for my classes, there is a photo of the day discussion, which involves talking about the Monday picture on a website, and the link is going to be in this file here. But there will be one of those each week, so those are very specific ones. But then you'll be able to access the graded discussions for the week. So there will be a graded discussion each week, and you can access that through the link here. You can access the class help discussions, which if we open that up has various different announcements and places where you can request help if you're having an issue with an assignment or you have a general question about the class. And then there's a few miscellaneous discussions. If you just want to chat with other classmates, there are some miscellaneous discussions available as well. You will see these last two will appear in every single lesson, and they will be exactly the same discussion board. So you can continue on with the discussions there. If you have class questions, you can access those from each of the specific lessons. Now, the next would be the assignments section. So as we clear this off, and we scroll down to the assignments section here, so lesson one assignments would include anything that you are assigned to do for that week. This would include everything that is graded for the week except for the discussion which was shown above. So the discussion would have been in the first section. In lesson one assignments, we have everything else that is graded for the week. In this case, for lesson one, there is an extra credit assignment you can look at. As with any extra credit, that is completely optional. There is a homework assignment. There is a lab, and actually two labs this first week. The first lab here, lab zero, is a relatively quick one. Just checking out that you have Flash and Java installed and that they will work for some of the labs that we'll be using in this class. And the second is a scientific methods lab that you will see. Now, some of these will link directly to the Dropbox. Others will have other sections that we can open up and other sections we can look at here. So as we clear that off, let's look at one of these just as an example for homework one. Homework one has not only has the homework assignment as well, but also has an answer key that will be visible after the assignment is completed. Lab 1 on the scientific methods actually contains a video introduction. So this is what I would do in a traditional class. I might spend 5 or 10 minutes at the beginning of class explaining the lab that we're going to do. Here's your chance to do that, to look at that as well. So instead of jumping right into the lab, take a few minutes and watch that video because you may find that it answers questions that you have or helps gives you some guidance. And then as with others, we see the lab and you'll be able to then complete that exercise and submit it to that Dropbox. The last thing on these in each lesson is the checklist. Lesson one checklist, and that if you go into that just gives you all of the assignments for the week. So what were you supposed to do in the lecture materials? Well, you should have read this chapter, you should have read this information, you should have watched the video lecture. What were the graded assignments for the week? These are all the graded assignments that are assigned for that week and their due dates. So it gives you a check at the end to make sure that you haven't missed anything. And then there are other things that I ask you to do that are not specifically graded, but are also important for this, maybe reminding you to begin working on certain assignments that may not be due this week, but will be due at future times. In this case, the observing discussion and the solar observations. You'll want to get started on that, but there's nothing due for them this week. Once you check off each of these elements in the checklist, then the next lesson will be visible to you. So if we're working through lesson one, once you're done with lesson one and you've checked that off, then lesson two will become visible. Lesson two will follow the exact same pattern. It will have lecture materials, it will have links to all the discussions, it will have links to the assignments, and it will have a checklist. Now, you can work in my classes up to 1 week ahead, meaning that if you finish the lesson one early and you want to start on lesson two, you can. However, if you finish both lessons one and two very early in the week, you cannot go on to lesson three. You can work as much as 1 week ahead, but to keep everybody on roughly the same track, I don't let you go any further ahead than that. And that process will continue. That is I want to note specifically that the lesson checklists are an absolute requirement in the class. You have to check them out. You have to check everything off on there in order to see the next lesson. So if you do not check off the lesson one checklist, you will never see lesson two. It will remain invisible, and there is no other way to access the assignments and the materials except through the lessons. I have it specifically designed that way to make sure you go through, and that way you never miss anything. Everything is specifically linked through the content. There is no other way in this class to access things like the Dropbox, the discussion boards, the quizzes, except through using the content structure. And that keeps everything very well organized for you, and make sure that you're not searching around for anything. You need only go through the content to be able to access everything you need for the lessons for that week. So that concludes this video recording that explains, give you a general idea of how to navigate the course. As always, if there are issues or concerns, please feel free to email me, and I will be more than happy to give additional guidance. So until next time, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.